Welcome to 2230, your source for comprehensive news coverage. Today, we delve into the recent developments within the Monetary Authority of Singapore, MAS, where significant changes are underway within its board of directors. The MAS, Singapore's central bank and financial regulatory authority, plays a pivotal role in shaping the nation's economic landscape. And on Thursday, May 2, MAS made headlines with the announcement of new appointments and reappointments to its board of directors. First and foremost, Minister for Transport, Chee Hong Tat, emerged as a prominent figure in this announcement. Alongside his duties as the second Minister for Finance, Mr. Chee is set to join the MAS board, embarking on a 3-year term commencing on June 1 and concluding on May 31, 2027. This move underscores MAS' commitment to leveraging diverse expertise in steering Singapore's financial future. Additionally, 5 esteemed individuals have been reaffirmed in their positions on the MAS board for 3-year terms, aligning with Mr. Chee's tenure. These include Deputy Prime Minister and Coordinating Minister for Economic Policies, Mr. Heng Swee Keat, Minister of State for Trade and Industry and Minister of State for Culture, Community, and Youth, Mr. Alvin Tan, former Chairman of Enterprise Singapore, Mr. Peter Ong, as well as Mrs. Deborah Ong and Mr. Ng Wai King. Their reappointment signals a vote of confidence in their leadership and strategic vision for MAS trajectory. Notably, DPM and Minister for Finance Lawrence Wong, along with Minister for Trade and Industry Mr. Gan Kim Yong, continue to hold pivotal roles within MAS as its chairman and deputy chairman, respectively. Their continued stewardship ensures stability and continuity in MAS governance. However, amidst these appointments comes the bittersweet news of Professor Tan Chur Chuan's impending departure. The esteemed former president of the National University of Singapore has contributed significantly to MAS since his appointment in June 2012. Professor Tan's tenure has been marked by his insightful contributions to board deliberations, notably as a key member of the Board Risk Committee. His departure leaves a void, but his legacy of clear thinking and strategic foresight will endure within MAS. In recognition of Professor Tan's contributions, MAS Chairman Lawrence Wong expressed gratitude for his invaluable insights and systematic approach to addressing complex issues. Professor Tan's role in bolstering MAS decision-making processes, particularly in technology and risk management, has left an indelible mark on the organization. Looking ahead, MAS Board, effective June 1, will boast a diverse lineup of seasoned professionals. From Lawrence Wong and Gan Kim Yong to newcomers like Chee Hong Tat and Alvin Tan, this ensemble represents a wealth of experience and expertise poised to guide MAS through the complexities of today's financial landscape. Join us in the comments section below to share your thoughts on these developments. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to 2230 for more in-depth coverage of Singapore's financial sector and beyond.
欢迎来到 G2230, 您的全面新闻报道来源。今天我们将深入探讨新加坡金融管理局 MAS 的最新发展，该机构的董事会正在经历重大变革。MAS 作为新加坡的中央银行和金融监管机构，在塑造国家经济格局方面发挥着至关重要的作用。在5月2日星期四，MAS 宣布了其董事会的新任命和重新任命，引起了公众的广泛关注。首先，交通部长徐方达成为了这一公告中的一员。除了担任财政部第二财政部长的职责外，徐先生将加入 MAS 董事会，并开始了从2021年6月1日至2027年5月31日的3年任期。这一举措凸显了 MAS 致力于利用多样化专业知识来引领新加坡金融未来的决心。此外，另外5位杰出人士也被重新任命为 MAS 董事会成员，与徐方达的任期相一致。这包括副总理兼经济政策协调部长王瑞杰、贸易和工业部部长兼文化、社区和青年部部长陈振声、前新加坡企业局主席王显明以及黄玉辉女士和黄伟京先生。他们的重新任命表明对他们的领导和对 MAS 未来发展方向的战略愿景的信心。 值得注意的是，财政部副部长兼财政部长王瑞杰和贸易和工业部长甘金勇继续担任 MAS 主席和副主席，他们的持续领导保证了 MAS 的稳定性和连续性。然而，在这些任命之中，也伴随着前新加坡国立大学校长陈楚川教授即将离任的消息。这位尊敬的教授自2012年6月起担任 MAS 以来，为该机构做出了巨大贡献。陈教授的任期以他对董事会讨论的深刻贡献而闻名，尤其是作为董事会风险委员会的重要成员。他的离职留下了一定的空白，但他的清晰思维和战略远见的遗产将在 MAS 内持续传承。为了表彰陈教授的贡献，MAS 主席王瑞杰对他的宝贵见解和解决复杂问题的系统方法表示了感谢。陈教授在增强 MAS 决策过程中的作用，特别是在技术和风险管理方面，给该组织留下了深刻印记。展望未来，从2021年6月1日开始， MAS 董事会将拥有一支多样化的专业人士团队。从王瑞杰和甘金勇到新加入的徐方达和陈振生，这个阵容代表着丰富的经验和专业知识，他们将引领 MAS 应对当今金融领域的复杂挑战。在下方评论区与我们分享您对这些发展的看法吧。别忘了点赞、分享和订阅 The2230， 以获取更多关于新加坡金融行业及其他领域的深度报道。